Okay, numerical methods in engineering with MATLAB. This is the second lecture. We are still in MATLAB basics. As I said before, the main objective of those lectures is to introduce how to utilize MATLAB in solving numerical methods in engineering. In the last lecture, we stopped at built-in MATLAB variables, and we are still in MATLAB basics as well in this lecture. So for example, if we want to find or to use MATLAB as a calculator, for example 2 minus 1 equal 1, one is stored in a built-in MATLAB variable called ANTS. So ANTS over 2 equal 0.500. Now ANTS is a built-in MATLAB variable. Okay, CLC. Another built-in MATLAB variable is EPS, which is very common built-in MATLAB variable, which is called floating point precision, which is about 2.2 to the power 10 to the minus 16. By also is a built-in MATLAB variable, which is a built-in MATLAB variable. Another famous built-in MATLAB variable is for infinity, which is a number larger than a real max, which is the result of evaluating 1 over 0. 1 over 0 gives a built-in MATLAB variable called infinity, INF. For example, the result of evaluating 0 over 0 gives none, which is not a number, which is also a built-in variable. Once we said built-in variable, this means that we couldn't use it in our own variables. Now let's go to a very important subject, which is matrices and vectors in MATLAB. It is good practice to know that all MATLAB variables are matrices. A vector is a matrix with one row or one column. It is called a vector. A scalar is a matrix with one row and one column. A character string is a row of column, vector of characters. How to create MATLAB variables. MATLAB variables are created with an assignment statement. For example, let us say x equal 2. In this way, we create a value to the variable x. The expression can involve in MATLAB or creating MATLAB variable can be manual entry, can be built-in functions that retains matrices, custom user-written functions that retain matrices, loading matrices from text files or mat files. For example, let's study how to create matrices and vectors by element by element. For example, let's create a vector, and we define this vector to be equal 1, 2, 3. This means that A is a vector of one row and three columns. And if you want to find the size of A, we can just write this command: size A equal 1, 3. One row, three columns. For example, okay, CLC. Here it is good practice to note that if you want to go back to the old commands, just use the up rows or down rows so you can review the old commands. For example, this is A, if you put semicolon between 1 and 2, this means that we will have, instead of have one row, three columns, we will have three rows and one column. Just put semicolons between those points. For example, if we defined b to be equal 1, 2, 3, 5, 9, 0. This means that we have three rows, two columns. Size of B gives us three rows, two columns. We put semicolon between 1 and 2. So this means that we are going to the next row. Okay, between 3 and 5 there is a semicolon. This means we go to the third row. This is very important. Okay, let's clean the screen. CLC, as I said before, clean the screen means that you clean the screen, but the data still existed in the memory of MATLAB. Okay, let's find A. A means 3, 2, 3, 1, 1, 4. If we want to define an operator called transpose, for example, B equal A transpose. For example, transpose. Transpose, once we put the percent, this means that it is a comment. So MATLAB never execute this once we put a percent. This just used for explanation. Okay, what does this operator means? This operator transforms the columns into row and the row into columns. Here we have 3, 2. This is the row, it becomes column. We have 3, 1, the row becomes column, and so on. This is very important. Transpose means that column is transformed to a row and row is transformed into a column. Now we are going to study overwriting variables. Once a variable has been created, it can be reassigned. For example, let's assign x to equal 2. Now we will assign x with x equal old x plus 3. This means that new x equal 5, while the old x equal 2. A new x equal 5, the old x equal 2, so we have x equal 5. Also, this is true for matrices as well. Here A equal, for example, 3 rows, 2 columns. Let's assign a new A to be equal A transpose. So A transpose. This means that a new A becomes another matrix as well. Okay, CLC, clean screen. We can also use function to create matrices and vectors as well. For example, we have different important built-in functions like line space. Line space, for example, let us define cx to equal line space from 1 to 4, and this is here 6. What does it mean? This means that we are going to create a vector starting from 1. Vector starting from 1, ending to 4. Okay. And the number of element is 6. Let's execute this. So we start from one, ending to four. We have six element. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 element. Okay, size of x. Size of x 1 to 6. Okay. If we write this, for example, x lattices from 1 to 4. This means that we will have the default. If we don't write how many elements we want, the default is 100. So let's execute this element. So we have 100. We will start from 1, ending from 4, but we will have 100. So the size of x in this way, sorry, x 1 to 100. This is the default. For example, okay, this means that we will start from 0, ending from 0.25. Okay, size u 1 to 100. Okay. Okay, let's have, for example, four or six. This means that we have one column, one row, six columns. But if you write transpose, this means that we'll have six rows and one columns. So we can use transpose as well. Clean screen, CLC. Clean screen. Clean screen. Here x equal, we can also find this. We can also define x to be equal from 0 to 2 by, and also using 6 element like this. We are using 6 elements. Also we can define y to be equal sine x. Okay, let's y sine x. So we take the sign of each element. We can also define z, okay, to be equal to cosine x. Okay, so we have here x, we have y equal sine x, we have z equal sine x. If we write here, for example, x, y, z will have x, y, z. We will have a table of a trigonometric. We'll have a table of a trigonometric functionless, but let's have this. For example, if you want to have in the shape of a matrix, we just like this. Okay, we put here a transpose, here y, here z, and you will have also x, y, z to be equal a matrix with this shape, three columns with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with six rows. The expression y equals sine x and z equals cosine x takes the advantage of vectorization. Clean screen. Okay. We have also another built-in variables like for example ones. Ones, okay, five. This means that we have a matrix with 5 by 5 filled with ones, filled with ones. For example, if we want to have also, this means the same, 5, okay, comma 5. This gives a matrix with 5 by 5 also. 4, this gives a matrix with 5 by 4 as well. We can also define this to be equal, Z equal to this matrix, okay, CLC. You can also like this. If you want to put semicolon, you suppress the output. Don't forget, when you use the semicolon, you suppress the output. We have also another built-in function called zeros. Zeros of 5 also gives a matrix filled with zeros. You can also create zeros with 2. This also gives this matrix. You can also define or assign it to equal A. So this gives you a matrix like this. You can also put a semicolon. You suppress this CLC. You can also have this. You can also put a transpose and have this data. This is very important skills in MATLAB. You can also define a function called I of 5 or 2, sorry. This gives a, the I function creates identity matrices of a specified size. CLC, for example, sorry, CLC, for example, A equal I of 3 by 3. Okay. This gives a 3 by 3 matrix, a identity matrix. But if we put this 7, what does it mean for us? It means for us that, as we have studied in linear algebra, the identity matrix is just used in square matrices. But here we defined a matrix with 3 multiplied by 7, 3 rows, 7 columns. This means that no identity matrix can be used in this dimension. This means that we just use 3 rows, the first 3 columns, to be defined as identity matrix. The next will be also, the next will be filled with zeros. The next will be filled with zeros. Now, let us have, for example, this, the opposite, 7, okay, and 3. Okay, this means that we have the first 7 column. This means that the first 3 columns also, the first 3 rows are used as an identity matrix, and the next rows are filled with, the next rows are filled with zeros, are filled with zeros. We have diagonal. So let's clean screen. Defined V equal, okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, this means that we have defined a vector with 1 row, 3 columns. Let's build a matrix based on this vector. So let's define A to be equal diagonal of v. This means that we built a matrix having the diagonal called 1, 2, 3. So this is v used to build a matrix with diagonal 1, 2, 3. We can also extract the diagonal from the matrix. We can also extract the diagonal from the matrix. For example, let's define V to be equal. Define to omega to be equal diagonal of A. Diagonal of A. Okay, so we extract from this matrix A, the matrix A, the diagonal, which is 1, 2, 3. So we can build a matrix based on the vector, and we can also extract the diagonal as well. Okay. Let's clean the screen. For example, if you use this, you can, for example, a function to create matrices. The action of diagonal function depends on the character and number of inputs. The polymorphic behavior of MATLAB function is common. For if you see this, for example, create a matrix with a specified diagonal. So this is a matrix based on this diagonal. You can use this order if you want to build a matrix. This is another command which is not too much different from the previous one. So let's have also B to be equal, for example. Okay, let's have B, and you can also extract the diagonal from you can also extract the diagonal from this matrix like this, 4, 7, 6. Sometimes I may copy and paste because I prepared the lectures in advance just to save the time of lecturing as much as possible. Now, clean screen. Here we will also go to subscript notation. Subscript notation, in fact, is very important. For example, let's define B as before. If we want to refer to the first element in B, we just write B, sorry, B 1 1. In this way, we refer to the first element. We refer to the first element. If we want to refer to the 1 3 1 3, this means that we refer to the first row and third column. This means that we refer to 2. Also, we can assign, for example, CLC, go to B. Okay, go to B. This is B. We can also write, for example, B. Sorry, B 1 1. Sorry, 1 1 equal equal 0. This means that we assigned another value. It was 1. Now it becomes 0. So if you want to change some element in the matrix, you can use this. So it is very important to use this notation. It is very important to use this notation. Assigning an element that is beyond the existing of dimension of the matrix causes the matrix to be resized. For example, let's have this. Okay. CLC. Okay. Paste. This is A. Sorry. Let's delete the semicolon just to see the matrix. Okay. For example, A 4 4 A 4 4 attempt to access A 4 4 index out of bounds because the size of A is 3 to 3. Now, if we want to assign it to be equal minus 10, this means that we are creating an idea based on an matrix based on the old matrix. For example, the old matrix is the old matrix is this, and we assign a value for row four columns equal minus 10. The other elements are assigned to be zero. So this means that assigning an element that is beyond the existing dimension of matrix causes the matrix to be resized. In other words, MATLAB automatically resizes matrices on the fly. Okay. We can also use this. A colon 4. What does it mean? This means that we create a vector from 1 to 4. The increment is 1. It is the default. The increment is 1. Is the default. CLC. Okay. Here. Okay. The increment is 1. But if we want the increment to be, for example, 0.1, 0.1, okay, this means that we have a matrix different from the other. I will start from 1, end from 4, into 4, but the increment is 0.1, so I will have a matrix, a huge matrix. Okay. Let's clean the screen and see if I have, for example, a vector, if I have a vector like this. Okay, if I have a vector like this, this means that I have vector from 1 to 5. If I put semicolon here, sorry, a comma, this means that a transpose of this. Okay. Let's have 5, for example, this one, delete this. Okay, what does it mean? This gives us the same 1 to 5. V is the vector row. Okay, let's use a colon as a wildcard to refer to an entire column of row or CLC. Here, CLC. Let's have A to be equal. Okay, let's have this. Okay, A to have this. So A. Okay, what does it mean here? If we put this, for example, this means that we need the all rows with one columns, 1 4 7 7, 1 4 7. If we have this order, we have 2 with, for example, what does it give us? 2 rows with all columns, the 2 and all columns. And then use a colon as a wildcard to refer to an entire column or an entire row. Here, entire column, entire rows with one column, entire columns with the second row. This is the meaning of this notation. This is the meaning of this notation. Okay. You can use too many notations. For example, this means that 1 to 4, 2 to 3. Take 1, 2, 3, 2 to 3, which is shown in this idea. For example, let's have, okay, I think it is good to stop here, and in the next lecture we will continue in matrices and vectors are very important subject. So in the third lecture, we'll start explaining how to manipulate the matrices. Thank you very much and see you in the next lecture, inshallah.